Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today we are going to go over how to delete blank cells in Microsoft Excel. So we are actually going to use three different methods to get rid of the blank cells inside of a spreadsheet. So on this sheet, we are going to use the filter option, and we're going to get rid of these blank cells right here. On this sheet, we're going to use the go to special method to get rid of these blank cells right here. And on our final example, we are going to use the find method to get rid of these blank cells. Also, we will have some additional training options for you at the end of this video, so stick around for that. So let's start here with our filter option. So on here, I would like to just filter out any times that have not been entered because these are invalid data entries. So if I go over to the data tab and I click on filter, I will see that these arrows have appeared at the top of my columns. So if I go over to the time one and I just uncheck the one that says blanks and say okay, I can now see that my data set only has entries that have a time entered. If you want to take that filter off, you can either click here where the filter icon is and reselect that blanks and say okay, or if I reset it by unchecking the blanks and say okay, I can also uncheck the filter button right here up on the ribbon, and I will see all my data once again. So that one is the filter option.
If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel and hit the bell button to get notified when we release our weekly videos.
Our next option is the go to special option. I can see here that I've had some deleted cells, and I would really like to just shift all my data to the left because that's going to line up my alphabetical letters right here. So in order to do that, I can press Control G on my keyboard, and that's going to bring up the go to window. And if I click this button here that says special, I can now select lots of different options for special cells here. But in my case, I want blanks. So I'm going to click blanks and say, okay. And now you can see all my blanks have been highlighted. So if I were to right click and go to delete and select the option for shift cells left and say okay, I can see that all of my data has moved to the left and now I've gotten rid of my blank cells that were over here. Now it didn't get rid of my blank cells on the right because they have already all shifted to the left, but I have filled in all the blanks over here. And then our final method is the find method. So first of all, I'm going to highlight A, B, and C because that's where I'm looking for my data because I want the find to exclude any of the columns that come after this. And then I'm going to press Control F on the keyboard to bring up the find and replace dialog box. So I'm just going to click on this and drag this over here so you can see a little bit better. But under the find what, I'm not going to enter anything, and that's going to tell Excel that I'm looking for a bunch of blanks. So then I'm going to click find all, and I can see all of my cells here that are blank. So if I click the first one and scroll all the way to the bottom and then hold down shift and click the last one, I can actually highlight all of my cells that are blank. And in this case, I'm going to go back to the home ribbon and I'm going to go to delete right here. And I'm going to go to delete sheet rows. And now I can see that I only have rows on here that actually have a valid time entry. This is very similar to the first example where we use filter, but the difference when using find and then using delete is you can't get the data back, whereas you can get it back when we use the filter example. So hopefully that gives you a good idea of how you can use these three different functions to delete some blank cells. And we showed you a few different ways, depending on what your needs are, to delete blank cells. Out on our blog, we actually have a bonus method for how to delete empty cells after the last cell with data, because sometimes you want to delete data past this point so that your file size can be smaller. I will include the link to our blog in the description below on YouTube if you would like to go there and see what that option is. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below and we'll get back to you. Thanks for watching and see you again next time.
If you want to learn more about Microsoft Excel and Office, join our Academy online course and access more than 1,000 video training tutorials so that you can advance your level and get the promotions, pay raises, or new jobs. The link to join our Academy online course is in the description.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.